was Endgame before Christmas, and all through the Zoom, our contestants were buzzing in their breakout rooms. With Craig setting fun games and Christmas galore, and David now frightened still tracking the scores. Christmas classics and hot takes, and Santa's ho ho ho, with gleeful excitement, bonuses, and no no no. I'm getting lazy now to continue this rhyme, so all I will say is, it's endgame time!
We're in the endgame now.
Oh, come on!
You are kidding me.
Oh, what?
This is horrific.
It's gonna save space time now!
Oh my god!
God damn it!
It's so annoying!
Well, good movies!
Yes, hello everyone. Craig has taken control once again for a festive endgame special. So, what's going to be happening today? Three different teams of previous guests all vying for that beautiful Christmas bonus at the end of this game. But who's going to win it? Who's going to gain the ultimate glory of having the Christmas crown? I don't know. I don't want to know until I've seen how their performances go. So, let's introduce the teams. First up, we have a pair of journalists who are incredible film buffs when it comes to Disney. One has watched the entire repertoire of Disney animated classics and the live-action remakes that are coming. The other one has ignored them altogether in favour of Disney Channel classics. Please welcome to the show Kelly Bishop and Stephen Jones.
Hello, my love.
Hello, guys. Hello.
How are we both doing?
I think we're good. I think we're ready to do this.
We're ready to win, Cal. That's what we're ready to do.
Well, I'm imagining, Stephen, you're going to be fighting for the joy of trying to get Eddie's million-dollar cook-off back into the film vault.
I don't know what you're on about. I honestly don't know what you're on about. Maybe.
Okay. Well, I'm looking forward to seeing your disappointment at no Disney Channel classics coming up later today. So, Kelly, you've got a couple of Christmas articles coming out for us, I believe.
I do. I have some non-Christmas, Christmassy films. So, films to watch if you want to feel festive, but not actually watch a Christmas film.
Okay, so what sort of films did you review? Because I know that David and I discussed last time about this, and we had various arguments about whether or not something like Mary Poppins should count as a Christmas film.
See, I like to put Mary Poppins in with, like, Christmassy feeling, but not technically a Christmas film, because there's nothing in that film that's set at Christmas. It just feels like Christmas. It's the same with Paddington and Sound of Music.
Oh yeah, I mean Sound of Music, I mean anything which is generally singing and up in the Alps is just a generally nice thing to endure. All right, well, excellent. I'm looking forward to seeing how you two perform later today. Next up, we have two of our guests from the Disaster Movie Special. Hopefully they will have learned from those experiences and avoid disaster today in this endgame. We have an actor and a video game streamer, so altogether theatrical creatives. Let's welcome to the show Chris Maxwell and Kieran Williams.
Hello.
Hello there.
How are you guys both doing?
Doing all right.
All right.
Doing all right.
Ready to get down to Quizness.
So, Kieran, last time you were on, you were telling us about the collection that you and your partner have in terms of disaster movie specials. Do you have a Christmas equivalent? Do you have one that you've been brushing up on for this quiz?
We do have Christmas Corner. It's not. We've watched Gremlins and Die Hard, and that's it so far. But I'm sure we'll be bashing through the rest of it.
Oh, I feel so bad because will that prepare you? I have no idea, because they're not instant what I would come for mind for Christmas, but obviously just set at Christmas. But truly going to Christmas. So, Chris, how are the preparations for Christmas? Your Christmas Carol audio performance going?
They're going really well, actually, mate. We're in the phases now of putting it all together. It'll be released as three episodes, 22nd, 23rd, and 24th. But also, as an added bonus, doing another audio project, which will be released this Friday.
Oh, fantastic.
Yeah, that's with Dramatic Moose, who I work with, of course. So that'll be released probably on Facebook and on YouTube channel as well.
Excellent. Well, I look forward to seeing them, and hopefully one day in the future they'll become part of the Endgame Festive Specials.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Excellent. And finally, and certainly by no means least, I mean, also if anyone can ever see the videos of what we're watching, you'll understand definitely not least. But we have a pair of comedians who have been on the show before in a partnership together and are the reasons that my therapy bills are as high as they are. Please welcome to the show Shelley Taylor and Lucy Fur.
Hello.
Right, first things first, we've got to talk about Lucy. That is a fantastic getup. So for the audience at home, please describe... God, that sounds weirdly sexual. I apologise, but please explain to the audience.
You want me to tell you what I'm wearing, yeah? You want to know what I'm wearing, you naughty boy?
Oh no!
Okay. Moving on.
So the PVC red PVC mask, red PVC gloves, and then a Santa hat. But then I just thought, I can't be bothered to do my makeup, so I'm just like barefaced and natural.
Oh, okay. Excellent. Great. So Shelley, how's life in the van?
Yeah, not bad.
This team is so messed up. I'm a weird old sex worker woman and you're living in a van. Why is this our life?
See, that is just the introduction I should have done for you, really.
Lady in the van.
So yeah,
living on Alan Bennett's driveway, really annoying him right now, you guys.
Alan Bennett, is that Gordon Bennett's brother?
No, it's the writer who wrote Lady in the Van.
I was making a joke, Sally. I can't tell.
You've had too much Botox. I can't tell the expression on your face.
I think that constitutes the part in my notes, which is just Lucy and Shelley's introduction. But all of you in the call will notice that we currently have somebody missing. We have what I consider to be my personal assistant, and in this situation, Santa's little elf, as well as my general little puppet. Let's introduce to the show, David Oscar. I see he got the costume I sent to him in the mail.
I haven't seen him yet.
I can't
even make noise.
Hello. I am here. I am a freaking elf. I am the elf.
Who are you? Oh,
dang. Yeah, I'm not alone.
You look adorable.
This is what happens when I berate Craig for the entire year.
Yeah, some people say that in the rare instances where I take control of the show that I abuse David too much. I don't. I gave him a gift. I gave him a lovely costume that he was mandated by contract to wear.
I think you look great. I'd let you work in my Christmas factory any day.
I was going to say, Dave, does it fit?
It's a bit short on the leg. That's what I say.
Is it like lederhosen?
Okay. So those are our competitors, but... before we go into the teams, before we go into the games, I believe that I sent David off on a little errand that I wanted you all to feel special before the games even started. So, David, how did that mission go?
Well, we've got like an exclusive clip from somebody very special for the Christmas festivities who's going to wish you all luck. And he's actually given you a bit of a preview to what you're getting for the Christmas this year, guys. We've given him the list, so we've recommended some really good stuff for him. You're going to love what's in there. Going to be under your Christmas tree this year. So do enjoy. Here is a festive message of good luck from the man himself.
Hello, and welcome to the festive endgame special with me, Father Christmas. I'm sorry I couldn't be there to join your podcast today, despite Craig's best efforts to kidnap me, but as you can imagine, I'm very busy at this time of the year. But I just wanted to wish you all the best of luck. And remind you that you're all winners, even if you come third, which is technically losing, but rest assured, you will always be winners in my eyes. Except you, Stephen Jones, because you haven't seen barely any of the Christmas films I've been in, including my favourite Christmas movie of all time, Die Hard. For the rest of you, however, I have plenty of gifts ready to give you in my sleigh. Shelley and her copy of Jack and Jill on DVD, Kieran and Chris and their copies of 2012 on 4K, Kelly's CD of Jump in My Car by David Hasselhoff, and Lucy, well, unfortunately, Lucy, I couldn't get you the writer and filmmaker Michael Dougherty like you asked for, but I've got you a signed photo of Dane Cook instead. Good luck, everybody, and have a very Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Santa.
Merry Christmas, Santa.
Wow, I'm outraged.
That's not on. I'm not impressed with that at all.
Same here.
He owes me alimony, all right? He owes me a lot of money, that man. The nerve and the cheek of him to come on here and make a joke out of it, I don't think it's funny at all. He owes me thousands, actually. Oh. I've been raising his kids for him for free, basically, and that's just not on. I'm livid, actually. I'm really upset that you do that to me on Christmas.
It's ironic, actually, because I was recently watching a review of a Santa film where they have to find a Mrs. Claus, and they're just like, and then he just finds her and is just like, you just live in the North Pole now, and she just does nothing, and they're like, why did you need a Mrs. Claus? She does nothing. It's like, give her her purpose. So... yeah,
I actually do a lot.
What was that?
Well, no, I'm saying I can believe that you would leave him, you know, like, because obviously he does, you know, he's in work all the time. And I just love people's faces doing that. Kelly just looked like she was going to cry at the start. She was.
Tear up a little bit, I won't lie. I love Santa. I love him.
And
I don't.
But that's because you haven't watched Die Hard. I'm sat here in a Die Hard jumper. I don't know how
well it's Die Hard.
Stephen, that's a good question. If you haven't really watched many Christmas films, how do you think you'll fare in this competition?
I like to live my life by luck, and I will win this competition by luck.
Oh, you poor, sweet, naive child. Okay, I think that's enough foreplay now. I think we should now get into the main event. So what's going to happen in this episode?
I'm sorry, I couldn't resist. I'm sorry. Go on.
Okay.
You'll be playing in a series of games against each other with various different rules. What will happen is that the performance of your team will determine how many overall team points you gain for that round, with the winner gaining 3 points, second place gaining 2 points, and then last place gaining 1 point. So at the end of this episode, the team with the highest overall team points will win. So the actual points you gain in the game itself don't add to the team's team score itself. So let's move on to the bonus points. So each of you and your peers will have sent a team name to David that I will now get a score in terms of how you'll be referred to for the rest of this episode. So, David, who are the teams?
So it's worth noting, as usual, Craig doesn't know which team is which, and there's not usually names cited. I think he might know one of them, but so the team names. First up, we have, I saw Mommy quizzing Santa underneath the quizzle-toe last night.
Oh, God.
The first team.
Sounds like a Frank Sinatra album that's, like, really poor. Like, really sad.
On the new Dolly Parton Christmas album.
It's just the addition of last night. Okay. So we have I saw Mummy quizzing Santa Claus underneath the quizzle toe last night.
Okay. If you want to add Claus as well, go for it. But yeah.
Oh, for God's sake. It doesn't actually say Claus?
No.
Right, we're taking that out. All right, second name.
Sycorax smear test.
Yep. Oh, jeez.
Yeah, I was proud of that one.
I mean, I'm not going to lie. I am in favour of healthy medical checks, and this is encouraging that. It is not particularly associated with Christmas, I would like to point out, but okay, cool. So
this
now...
Sycorax is for all times of year.
Don't give it away whose name it is.
Oh, yeah, because the Sycorax is such a wide and varied reference.
Okay.
The final team name, please, David.
And we have C3P Ho Ho Ho.
Okay.
I didn't know it had to be with Christmas.
At no point did either of us say, oh, it should be Christmas.
I mean, it didn't necessarily have to be Christmas.
Okay, so the way that the bonus points will work is I will award 2 bonus points to my favourite team name, one bonus point to the second place, and unfortunately no points for the first round. So I'm going to give the bonus 2 points. I don't know. You know what? I'm feeling generous. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give a bonus 2 points to the most creative team name there, which is Sycorax Smear Test.
Yay!
However, I genuinely like all of the team names, so I'm not going to let anyone go away with 0 points. So both I Saw Mummy Quizzing Santa Underneath the Quizzle Tree Last Night and C3P Ho 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 will get one bonus point. I said Quizzle Toe.
You said Quizzle Tree.
It begins.
What the hell's a Quizzle Tree?
We're suddenly in a Dr. Seuss book.
So that's 2 bonus points to Lucy and Shelley, I assume.
How did you know?
Out of curiosity, so I assume that C3P Ho 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 is Chris and Kieran?
No.
Oh!
No. Yeah,
interesting. So,
what you don't know about me is I'm a big fan of puns.
Okay.
Okay, that might serve you well then later on in the show.
Ooh.
Sorry.
Good stuff.
Okay, so basically, so C3P Ho 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 is Kelly and Stephen. So then I Saw Mummy Quizzing Santa Underneath the Quizzle Toe Last Night is
it probably
Kieran
should have claws. And I think I asked David to sing it.
We'll discuss this later.
It's a high note song either.
No, just start low. Go,
I saw mommy quizzing Santa underneath the quizzle toe last night.
That's it. That's all I wanted.
Yes, that's good. Mate,
I was thinking of the Jackson 5 version. That'd be too high.
Okay. And you know what I said about nobody's getting 0 points? I was wrong. David's getting 0 points for that performance. All right. Let's move on to an actual game. So, first game is We Finish Each Other's
Sandwiches.
Exactly. Way, somebody said it. I might give a bonus point for that. Anyway, so this is the Christmas movie special for this game. So, let's move on to the rules of this game. So, Christmas films are so memorable, aren't they? So wonderfully quotable. But can you finish those quotes? You are going to hear quotes from various Christmas movies, and we want you to write down what you think the next part of the quote is. You will get 1 point for your 1 point if one of the members of your team gets it, and you get 3 points in total if both members have it. No conferring is allowed. Okay, we ready?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Clip number one. So first we're going to start with a wonderful classic, It's a Wonderful Life. So what happens every time a bell rings? So we'll start with Lucy.
Is the little girl from It's a Wonderful Life, and the dad picks her up on his shoulders and she says, "Teacher says every time a bell rings, an angel gets its wings." And then the dad goes, "Oh, that's right." In that exact
scene.
Okay, so just going across the line now. So Kieran has written down, "An angel gets its wings." Chris, what did you put?
Oh, I honestly didn't know this one, so I just went for a ballpark. I went, "Every time a bell rings, Santa's flown over a house."
That's cute.
Shelley, what did you go for?
An angel gets its wings.
An angel gets its wings. Kelly?
An angel gets its wings.
And Stephen?
I obviously went for Santa pays his taxes. Of course.
Okay. David, could you reveal the correct answer?
Look, Daddy, teacher says every time a bell rings, an angel gets his wings.
That's right.
So we even included the "that's right" part.
Oh, that's right.
I think I prefer that version. I think that's better.
Oh, that's right.
I love Jimmy Stewart. Why are you doing this to me?
Oh, that's
right. Oh, that's just how people talked back then. It's not their fault.
Okay. So just checking then. So basically, so Lucy, Shelley got it right. Kieran and Kelly got it right. Stephen and Chris were unfortunate to that round. So are we ready for the next clip?
Yep.
Cool.
Well, I don't know what to say, except it's Christmas and...
Okay, so that so the film that this is from is National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation.
I'll act it out if you want.
I'll play once more.
Well, act it out.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know what to say, except it's Christmas and... I don't know what to say, except it's Christmas and...
I genuinely thought David had played the clip again.
David had played the clip again, but Kieran was talking over it.
That's fine. I've got it.
Yeah, whatever. I don't know it.
I'm in that boat with you.
Okay, we'll start with Lucy again.
I don't know what to say, except it's Christmas and you've got a big old horse.
I expected nothing less of you. And that's kind of a shame. Okay, Kelly.
I went for Holiday Spirit because I have not actually seen National Lampoon.
Okay, Chris.
I don't know what to say, except it's Christmas and I thought it'd be arousing.
It's a theme.
Oh, okay. This is fine. Stephen, any ideas?
I went for quite a logical one. I went for, I don't know what to say, and it's Christmas and I need to get a turkey.
Okay. We'll go to Shelley first, then Kieran.
And I'm in love. Because, whatever.
Okay. We'll now go to Kieran, because I think Kieran's got the right answer, and it perfectly represents how I feel right now. Kieran, what's the right answer?
I don't know what to say, except it's Christmas, and we're all miserable.
Okay, David, play that clip.
Well, I don't know what to say, except it's Christmas, and we're all in misery.
We're all in misery. I will award the point for that because I think given that it was basically miserable.
No one else got it.
No one was even close.
I think mine was close.
Clip number three. Let's move on to clip number three. This is now Elf.
I plan out our whole day. First we'll make snow angels for 2 hours, and then we'll go ice skating, and then we'll eat a whole roll of Toll House cookie dough as fast as we can, and then, to finish...
Everyone's just gonna think, I'm on a team on my own.
Okay. Right, okay, so...
We'll now go to the answers. Lucy, what is your answer?
And then we'll do a money shot on your face.
Right.
Going across the line, Kieran...
I have got nothing. I couldn't even think of a joke answer because I've been so stunned for the last minute and a half.
Okay. Chris?
I got nothing. I put that on a big fatty and some nachos.
Hell yeah.
Shelley, what did you go for?
Oh, Shelley or Kelly? Which one?
I said
you have to be more specific on this one.
I said Shelley, but...
Go for it, Shelley.
Well, I think you're right, but I put, we'll eat syrup on spaghetti, because I remember him doing that.
He does do that.
And then I put, sing, because I know he makes him sing for him.
Okay. Kelly?
We'll snuggle.
And Stephen?
I just went to finish, we'll eat bread with a ginger, so I thought I'd just switch up the gingerbread.
Okay. So,
David?
I plan out our whole day. First we'll make snow angels for 2 hours, and then we'll go ice skating, and then we'll eat a whole roll of Toll House cookie dough as fast as we can, and then, to finish, we'll snuggle.
A big fatty and some nachos.
We'll snuggle.
We'll snuggle.
I didn't hear again. I feel sorry for Kelly, because I feel like you actually care about this and feel really Christmassy, and you've just been sent in with some weird old hooker.
No,
and then,
fine.
And people that don't care about Christmas.
Nah,
I care about Christmas!
Okay.
Megan, you know the answer!
Right, number four. Let's go for number four.
Okay.
This is from the original Miracle on 34th Street.
The original?
Oh, I don't think so. Christmas is still Christmas.
Oh, Christmas isn't just a day.
Okay, so as usual, we'll start with Lucy.
Christmas isn't just a day, it's a way of life.
A way of life. Kelly?
Christmas isn't just a day, it's a feeling, or something else wanky like that.
Okay, so it's a feeling or something else wanky like that.
That's not the answer. I put it specifically okay. In brackets, so it's not part of the answer.
Okay.
Chris.
Oh, man, I have no clue. I mean, no, nothing.
Okay, Shelley.
I also put it's a feeling, but I forgot to write or something wanky like that.
Yeah. Stephen.
So I just went for Christmas isn't just a day, it's a lifestyle.
A lifestyle. And Kieran.
It's a feeling.
Okay. Is anyone correct? We will see. David, play the clip.
Oh, I don't think so. Christmas is still Christmas.
Oh, Christmas isn't just a day. It's a frame of mind.
It's a frame of mind.
So close.
Martial arts so film, close. Is it? Christmas is a... is a frame of mind. Santa's like training some young like elven monk. He's running along the North Pole, dragging the sleigh along, and Santa's like, faster! You must be the best elf ever!
Presents over his shoulders. Like,
karate chopping a nice block.
Christmas elf you are.
Are we ready for clip number 5?
Yeah.
So... I'm going to be upfront now. We've now gone back. We're going back to childhood. This is the animated classic, How the Grinch Stole Christmas.
And the Grinch with his Grinch feet, ice cold in the snow, stood puzzling and puzzling. How could it be so? It came without ribbons. It came without tags.
So it's basically the How Did Christmas Come speech, and the specific part we freezed on was it came without ribbons, it came without tags. And instantly, I am fearing any answer we may get from Lucy.
It came on the carpet emptying its big hairy ball bags. I'm sorry.
I thought it was going to rhyme.
It did. Tags and bags do rhyme. More's the pity. Okay, is everyone else ready to give their answer?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Kieran. Kieran?
I can't hear Kieran.
We can't hear you anymore.
Kieran. Yeah, I can't hear him.
All right.
Oh, there we go.
Oh, there we go.
I've got nothing.
You got nothing. Okay.
Stephen, how did you get on?
Not very well, my friend. I just went for it came with a buy one, get one free, or get your money back. I don't know.
Shelley?
I said it came without buttons, or something, or rags.
Kelly?
Some mums went to Tesco and filled up their bags.
And finally, Chris.
It came without ribbons, it came without tags, it came with a copy of a porno mag.
And a fanny and some nachos.
Oh, yeah.
Let's go for the reveal. Were any of those answers correct?
And the Grinch with his Grinch feet, ice cold in the snow, stood puzzling and puzzling. How could it be so? It came without ribbons. It came without tags. It came without packages, boxes, or bags.
It came without packages, boxes, or bags. So that's unfortunately...
I did rhyme bag.
Yeah, that is true.
Are you seriously asking for some form of bonus point? Because you happen to get...
Give one to Lucy, I would like one as well.
Oh yeah, I mean, that was...
Bags, yes.
I'm feeling festive. I will give half a mark for the fact that you got the last word. So that's half a mark.
I love it.
Okay.
Can I get a third of a mark because I had the last two letters of that word?
I'm on that.
Well, no, because it's a Seuss. So you knew that anyway. All right, are we ready for the are we ready for the next one?
Yeah.
Yeah. Might as well be.
Let's venture into the world of Home Alone 2.
I'm going to give you to the count of three to get your lousy, lying, low-down, four-flushing carcass out my door. One, two.
Okay, so Lucy.
Merry Christmas, you filthy animal.
Chris.
No, I got nothing.
Chris has got nothing. Shelley.
I also put Merry Christmas, you filthy animal, because I think it changes in the second one from Keep the Change.
Kelly, what did you go for?
Merry Christmas, you filthy animal.
Stephen.
I went for Merry Christmas, you filthy animal, and then I added and a Happy New Year, because I think he says that at the end.
Question is, do I penalise you if he doesn't say that?
You don't.
Okay.
Craig, can I get bonus points for the fact that I know that the film that you're referencing that's within the universe of Home Alone is called Angels with Dirty Faces? And I think the second one is called Angels with Dirtier Faces. And it's like a fake film noir film that they just made for Home Alone. I think the second one is Angels with Dirtier Faces.
So it's Filthy Souls.
Oh, so close.
It's Angels with Filthy Souls and then Filthier Souls in Home Alone 2.
Yep.
I've got an answer.
What's the answer?
And don't come back, you filthy animal.
Okay, David, what? Play the reveal.
Three. Merry Christmas, you filthy animal.
So it's Merry Christmas, you filthy animal. So that's points. So that's points for Shelley and Lucy, for Kelly and Stephen, 1 point for Kieran and Chris. Okay, are we ready for the next clip?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's go to Jingle All the Way.
I'm here and... oh, these cookies! I gotta get the recipe from Les.
Oh, Les. I know Les. Yeah.
It is Liz, but... Liz. It's not Les Dennis.
See, that's what was throwing me.
It's Les Battersby.
Okay, Liz. All right, I've got to get the recipe from Liz. And then the other person responds and says, haven't you heard? Liz died. She was riddled with cancer.
Jingle All the Way, yeah.
Harrowing.
Chris, what do you think the answer is?
Excuse me. Put that cookie down now.
Oh,
of course.
Stephen, what did you put?
I wish I put that, but I went, that's not a cookie, that's my child.
Shelley, what did you put?
I put, hi, I'm Troy McClure.
Okay.
Same guy.
Kelly, what did you put?
I have to make them for the Christmas party.
Kieran, what did you put?
Put that cookie down now. Who told you could eat my cookies?
David, play that reveal.
I'm here and... oh, these cookies! I gotta get the recipe from Les. Put that cookie down! Now!
Yep, it's Put That Cookie Down Now. Such a classic. Classic. Such a
I was
classic.
Really hoping I was right.
Yes.
Okay, are we ready for the final clip?
Yeah, why not?
So we're going to finish up with A Christmas Carol, but which version of A Christmas Carol did we go for? Well, obviously we went for The Muppets Christmas Carol.
The best one.
Our assets are frozen!
How would the bookkeepers like to be suddenly...
unemployed!
Do you know what, Mr. Scrooge? I've had enough of you, and I'm going to start a union. Deal with it.
Good old Victorian unions. Okay, Kelly, what did you go for?
But it's Christmas.
Chris, what did you go for?
Unemployed at Christmas.
Shelley, what did you go for?
I put, well, the rats all scream and they go, ah, we're on an island in the sun, pretending they're not freezing.
Okay. Stephen, what did you go for?
I went on the tips of him saying unemployed because just like Prince Andrew, I won't sweat to do it.
Oh, God. Kieran, what did you go for?
This is my island in the sun.
Yeah.
Okay, so, David, play that reveal.
Yeah, our assets are frozen.
How would the bookkeepers like to be suddenly
unemployed? This is my island in the sun.
I believe you convinced them once again, Mr. Scrooge.
Yep. So, I'm going to be generous, even though nobody answered Heatwave. But enough people said this is my island in the sun that I think that I can ward that opponent.
They're all in, like, hula skirts suddenly.
Yeah.
It's great.
I love the one who's just there like, hoi, hoi.
So, final scores from that round. Kelly and Steven scored 6.5. Kieran and Chris scored 7. And Lucy and Shelley scored 7.5.
So how?
There were enough times where the both of you knew the answer, which so that got you the bonus points. So, David, how do the overall team scores look after that round?
So that is Sycorax smear test with 5 points, Mummy quizzing Santa underneath the quizzletoe last night with 3 points, and C3P ho 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 with 2 points.
So it's still very much everything to play for. Excellent. Let's now move on to round number 2. Welcome to the 12 films of Christmas.
Ooh.
Obviously, it's Christmas, so we're going to have a little bit of Christmas caroling. However, we're going to do it with a bit of a twist. So, we've replaced the lyrics of the 12 Days of Christmas with clues that reference various films or franchises, and we would like you to name them. So you get a point for each correct answer, and it's advisable that you're able to confer if you can. So like I said, if you're able to message each other, or like I said, in the situation with Lucy and Shelley, we'll let you discuss what the answers are. We'll bring you the lyrics on screen, but basically I will sing them. So are we ready?
Yes.
Okay. David, let's do this. On the 12th day of Christmas, my true love gave to me 12 men a-raging, 11 Oscar statues, 10 poetic insults, 9 alien districts, 8 Christmas couples, 7 evil exes, 6 magic stones, 5 armies, 4 nations, 3 wishes, 2 dark side rules, and an orange creature speaking for the trees. Okay, so those are hints towards the 12 different films that you're looking for.
They're not all Christmas films, are they?
No, some of them may be Christmas films, some of them may not be Christmas films. I would also say that some of them will have the corresponding numbers in the title, some of them won't. So don't think you have to try and think of films that have that number in it.
Mad how 2 and 1 just jam so well together.
That's the song we're going to end the entire podcast on, guys. It's the Christmas Carol, all of us singing together.
Me and Shelley have a song prepared.
Oh, no, we don't now.
No, we do.
No, you don't.
We do. That's the baby.
Oh, look at that. Time is now up. We'll stop all of this and go to the answers. We'll start with Sycorax smear test. What do you think 12 men a-raging represents?
12 angry men.
It's 12 angry men, yeah.
12 angry men. I saw Mommy quizzing Santa Claus underneath the quizzletoe last night.
Yeah.
Okay. And C3P Ho Ho Ho.
12 Angry Men.
And David? It's 12 Angry Men.
Woo!
Woo!
So, 11 Oscar statues. Shelley and Lucy, what do you think that represents?
So, I always think Return of the King, but I know, like, Ben-Hur won loads and other things have won loads, but I don't know, I'd be inclined to go for Return of the King. What about you, Lucy?
Yeah, let's go with Return of the King, although there is one further down that I thought was a Lord of the Rings one. I can't remember which one it was. Five Armies?
Yeah, but that's Hobbit.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so your final answer is...
I don't know geeky stuff. I have a life.
We'll say Return of the King then, yeah?
Return of the King. Okay. C3P Ho Ho Ho?
We went with Titanic.
Titanic? And I saw Mummy quizzing Santa Claus underneath the Quizzletoe last night.
See, I'm thinking it's probably a Lord of the Rings.
Yeah.
One of them. Should we say Return of the King or should we do the first one?
No, it's definitely Return of the King that won stuff.
Oh, I'm sure they all won stuff, but there's too many things. There's too many times in that film. Too much of that film. But yeah, why not?
Okay, so 11 is Return of the King.
Wow.
Phew. Nice and Kieran.
Well done, Shell.
So,
yay.
10.
10 poetic insults.
10 things I hate about you, because it's Shakespeare, right? I would have thought.
10 things I hate about you. I saw Mummy quizzing Santa Claus.
I didn't ask
the quiz
on that one. Oh,
sorry. I thought you
10 things I hate about you.
Yeah, she agreed.
I agree.
C3P Ho Ho Ho?
Yeah, we went 10 things I hate about you as well.
Show me 10 things I hate about you.
It is.
So 9 alien districts. What do we think for this one?
District 9, isn't it?
Yeah.
Any other answers apart from District 9?
No, District 9.
District 9.
Show me District 9.
District 9.
Next, we have 8 Christmas couples.
Ooh.
Love Actually.
Yeah, that was the only thing I had written down for this.
Okay.
Love Actually is.
Okay, so who had Love Actually written down? Was it all 3 teams or?
Yeah.
Is it Love Actually? Love Actually, yes. Now we have 7 evil exes.
Scott Pilgrim versus the World.
Yeah.
Scott Pilgrim.
Yep. Scott Pilgrim? Scott Pilgrim versus the World. Excellent. Now we have 6 magic stones.
I thought Avengers. Do I need to be more specific? I don't know.
If you want to say Avengers as a franchise, that's fine.
Lucy, what did you think?
I think it would be the Infinity War one, because that's all about the stones.
But you think it's Avengers, yeah? Okay.
Yeah,
cool.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, we'll go Infinity War then.
Okay, the other teams, what did you go for? So we'll start with C3P Ho Ho Ho.
So we went for Avengers Endgame.
Okay. And I saw Mummy quizzing Santa Claus underneath the Quizzletoe last night.
Avengers. Yeah. It was either or. That was it. Like.
Marvel right. Cinematic Universe.
Show me Avengers.
Yep.
Oh.
I would have accepted Avengers, Avengers Infinity War, or Avengers Endgame, because they're the only films that they all appear together properly.
Do you ever think about the fact that all the Avengers franchise is just like military propaganda? Me neither. Continue.
Yeah, la 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 la.
5 Armies.
Hobbit.
Apparently that's a Hobbit thing.
Okay, Hobbit. I saw Mummy quizzing Santa Claus.
Hobbit.
And C3P Ho Ho Ho.
The Hobbit.
Hobbit.
Show me the Hobbit. Yep, the Hobbit Battle of the 5 Armies. Now we've got 4 nations.
Luce, what do you think? I've got something...
Is it Avatar? Because that's the 4 nations.
When you say Avatar, could you be more specific?
The terrible one where it's the remake of the cartoon.
So, The Last Airbender.
That is not the terrible Avatar, but...
They're both terrible.
I put Four Lions.
So you've got to make a choice between Four Lions or Last Airbender.
Last
Airbender.
Last Airbender. Let's go.
I saw Mummy quizzing Santa Claus.
Oh, Last Airbender, yeah. Sorry.
Last Airbender and C3P Ho Ho Ho.
Last Airbender.
Same for us.
What did you say, Kelly?
I don't know. Words just didn't come out of my mouth.
The last Airbender.
No, The Last Airbender.
All right, show me Last Airbender. It's The Last Airbender.
Lucy.
You're all very welcome. Lions.
Three wishes.
I kind of wanted it to be Four Lions.
Oh, yeah, Shelley, been braining all of you.
Four Lions?
Surely that would just be... Four Lions. Just tell you the title.
Okay.
What do we have for three wishes?
It's Aladdin, isn't it?
Aladdin, yeah. Aladdin.
Kelly and Stephen.
Yeah, Aladdin.
Chris and Kieran.
Yeah, Aladdin. Yeah.
Show me Aladdin.
Aladdin.
I'm going to move swiftly on. Two Dark Side Rules.
It's one of the Star Wars films, but I don't know which one.
Again, you can say it's a franchise.
Star Wars.
It seems fitting after that answer to ask C3P Ho Ho Ho.
Star Wars.
And finally, I saw Mummy quizzing Santa Claus underneath the Quizzle Toe last night.
Star Wars, but Star can Wars I be pedantic? Empire?
Okay, show me Star Wars or the Empire. We just went for Star Wars.
It's just the two. I figured it'd be the second one.
Well, it's first mentioned in Phantom Menace properly, but... Okay, and finally, an orange creature speaking for the trees.
The Lorax!
The Lorax. Even though I did want to put a giant Terry's chocolate orange just speaking for the trees.
You'd have to veto that idea.
I was overruled.
Speaking for the trees.
You'd have to de-veto that idea.
I'll give him credit for that. That was... No other situation would that have worked perfectly.
Yeah, that's alright.
Danny DeVito movies that someone is disagreeing on. It's a situation that does not often come up, but I seized the opportunity and I'm proud of myself.
He's out punning Steve and Kieran.
So the final scores after that. The team C3P Ho 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 had 11 points, and joint first for that round are Sycorax Smear Test, since I saw Mummy quizzing Santa Claus underneath the Quizzle Toe last night, with 12 points each.
Can I be really pedantic, and it's not like I want to win or anything. Titanic did win 11 Oscars. It's just not the one you've got written.
I know, I was thinking when I was like, as it came up, I was like, Craig...
It's just not the one that's written there. And yeah. There's nothing in that clue that would suggest that it's Lord of the Rings. Yeah.
So an article I read did not list Titanic as being one of the biggest Oscar winners for some reason, so I apologise in that case. David, can you verify that's true?
Oh, I see what's going on. There's some riggery and buffoonery and...
Radio Times. So
it is 11.
I do. I've come with the receipts, honey.
It's 11. Okay. So right, are there 3 points each?
Or? All three teams get 3 points each.
Why am I
doing
one clapping?
It's satisfying. Because they only benefited us.
Yeah, I know.
Okay. Let's move on to the next game. So this is an individual play round. You get the points as long as somebody on your team get it. Welcome to Ho Ho Who?
How I feel most days.
Let's look at the rules for this game. Ah, Santa, the only old white man for whom it is socially acceptable to invade people's homes. As so many iconic actors have taken him on, but can you tell the difference? We're going to play you different versions of his iconic line, and we want you to tell us who the actor is and which film it is. 1 point for each answer. Conferring is allowed. Ho, 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 damn, this is going to be interesting. Okay. Let's go to clip number one.
We're doing it. Let's go!
Oh, oh, oh! Wait. Time out, really?
So that was from the trailer for the film, but it's still the ho, ho, ho used in the film. So let's start then. Let's go to the stop. So we'll start with I saw Mommy quizzing Santa Claus underneath the quizzletoe last night. Who was Santa number one?
I've got Tim Allen, but I was tempted to write Tim Allen for all of them.
Okay.
That was I.
So you've gone for Tim Allen. Chris, who have you gone for? Okay. We'll now ask C3P Ho Ho Ho.
No idea.
No, I just take a random guess. Just one thing comes to my mind. Probably have to go with Danny DeVito.
You've gone for Danny DeVito? Okay, and finally, we have Sycorax Smear Test.
I think it was Tom Hanks in Polar Express.
I agree.
David, did anyone get it right?
We're doing it. Let's go!
Oh, oh, oh! Wait. Time out, really?
That was J.K. Simmons from Klaus.
Oh.
What?
My friend worked on that film.
It's a great film.
And a great actor.
Yeah. Oh, damn.
Okay.
Can you go ho, ho, ho?
I don't go ho, ho, ho. That's a myth.
So we'll start with Sycorax Smear Test. Who do we think number two was?
I thought it was Billy Bob Thornton in Bad Santa.
Okay. I saw Mommy quizzing Santa Claus underneath the quizzletoe last night.
I also have Billy Bob Thornton. And it's written down and everything.
Okay. And finally, C3P Ho Ho Ho.
I thought it was Kurt Russell.
From?
Christmas Chronicles.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. So, David, did anyone get that
Can
right?
Can you go ho ho ho?
I don't go ho ho ho. That's a myth.
Kelly and Steven get a point.
No.
Oh, they get 2 points, actually, because they got the actor and the film. That was Kurt Russell from The Christmas Chronicles.
That means I've got 5 wrong.
Okay. Reveal number 3.
Boys, easy.
Oh.
We'll start with C3P Ho Ho Ho.
So we went for Jim Carrey.
I think it's in The Grinch.
Okay. Sycorax Smear Test?
I put Tim Allen, Santa Claus. I don't know. This was hard.
Okay, and I saw Mommy quizzing Santa Claus underneath the quizzletoe last night.
Do you have anything, Chris?
Should we just do a guess?
Tim Allen, Santa Claus.
Yeah, why not?
David.
Ho, 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 no, boys, easy.
Oh.
That was Paul Giamatti. And David, what was the film?
Fred Claus.
Oh yeah, we've all seen that. Yeah.
My number one Christmas film,
the festive favourite.
It's a Christmas film I've ever watched.
That's in a scene where Vince Vaughn is getting attacked by CIA elves.
Of course.
Yeah.
Okay. Clip number 4.
Ho, ho, ho.
That's a ho, 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 ho.
We'll start with Sycorax Smear Test. Who did you think this Santa was?
Benedict Cumberbatch.
Tim Allen, Santa Claus. I've no clue.
Okay. I saw Mommy quizzing Santa Claus underneath the quizzletoe last night.
I've got another guess, Chris.
Yeah, go for it, man.
My guess is Richard Attenborough in Miracle on 34th Street.
That's what I was going to guess, actually.
Interesting. And finally, we have C3P Ho Ho Ho.
Tim Allen in The Santa Claus.
If we say it for everyone, it will be right.
Like, I feel like at some point, we're just all hoping that Tim Allen is an answer.
So, David, were any of those guesses correct?
Ho, ho, ho.
That's a ho, 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 ho.
It's Jim Broadbent from Arthur Christmas.
God damn it.
Some of you might be right if you do think outside the box on the last one, because you've all if you go with what you've been saying but go also outside the box, you might get it.
Oh, how have your attention. Stop the work, please.
I saw Mommy quizzing Santa Claus underneath the Quizzletoe last night. Who do you think the last one was?
Well, I had Kurt Russell, but obviously that's not right. So Tim Allen.
Why not Tim Allen?
So you're going Tim Allen Santa Claus.
It would be a real wrong and move to not include Tim Allen the Santa Claus in this round.
Okay, Sycorax smear test.
Tim Allen as Scrooge McDuck.
My guess is it's the guy who was Santa Claus before Tim Allen pushed him off the roof and killed him.
Oh.
Because he does say ho, ho, ho at some point.
Okay. So which of those... Okay, so those are separate guesses. And finally, C3P ho, ho, ho.
Just Tim Allen. I hope it's Tim Allen. I'm going to go with the Santa Claus 2 with like the stipulation
for
the sequel.
Damn it. Stephen, what were you going to say?
I've got to stay with my partner on this one and say Tim Allen, Santa Claus 2.
Oh, all right, let's do the reveal.
So first things first, we'll do, is it Tim Allen?
We all really hope it is.
Yay!
Now, is it the Santa Claus?
Oh, how? Have your attention. Stop the work, please.
It's the Santa Claus 2.
Yes. Get in there. I was far too pleased about that.
Yeah.
I'm really upset with myself for how pleased I was about that.
As you were
that.
Like, I'm in an R and I was like, oh my God.
Get in there.
So at the end of that round, with 1 point each, we have Sycorax smear test and I saw Mummy quizzing Santa Claus underneath the Quizzletoe last night. But winning that round with 4 points, we have C3P Ho Ho Ho.
Wow. Oh.
So David, what are the scores looking like now as we come into the final two games?
So you've got Mummy quizzing Santa Claus underneath the Quizzletoe last night with 8 points. You have Sycorax smear test with 9 points, and you have C3P ho 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 with 8 points. So Sycorax smear test is in the lead by 1 point with the other new drawing.
I was expecting
you to read them in reverse order, so that was a bit of a shock to me.
it's just the way it's
9 points and 8 points.
Okay, let's go into game number 4. Welcome to Hallmarking the Occasion.
Oh no.
So, this is our first quickfire round.
Ugh.
So let's look at the rules. The Hallmark Channel are absolute demons when it comes to releasing movies that barely anyone will watch. This is even true at Christmas. This is going to be a quickfire round where we will give you the title of a film and we want you to say if it is one of the 40 movies that will be showing on their channel, the 40 Christmas movies that they've made specifically for their channel. If you think that is a Hallmark, so if you think it is going to be a film on the Hallmark channel, you'll say Hallmark. If you don't think it is, you say No Mark. So this is the kicker here. For every correct answer, you will get a point. For every wrong answer, you lose a point. So you've got to be certain if you're going to go for it. So this is where you'll have to indicate to me using some form of sign that you want to answer. Okay, so Kelly is going to hold up a goose. We've got heavy rain from Shelley, a wave from Lucy, a felt tip marker, and a Lego Batman and a pen. Okay, so excellent. Are we ready? So like I said, this is quick fire. So... Christmas by Starlight. So that's Sycorax smear test?
No.
It is a Hallmark special.
Motherfucker. Sorry.
It's only the beginning of the round.
The Christmas House. So that's C3P Ho Ho Ho.
No mark.
It is a Hallmark. A Tennessee Christmas Carol. That is I Saw Mommy Quizzing Santa Claus.
No mark.
It's no mark, so that's a point.
Yes.
So they actually do have a film called A Nashville Christmas Carol, which we just adapted the title slightly. Okay. A Christmas Tree Grows in Brooklyn. That is Sycorax smear test. Shelley.
No mark.
It's a Hallmark.
Oh my God.
I've never heard these, so don't go by my reaction. If I might just be laughing because it sounds ridiculous.
Okay.
Shell, I don't think we're going to win this one, babe.
Next up.
I'm just not going to answer.
A Shiny Joyous Christmas. That is C3P Ho Ho Ho, Stephen.
No mark.
It's a no mark, so that's a point. The actual film is A Bright and Merry Christmas. Five Star Christmas. That is I Saw Mommy Quizzing Santa Claus, Kieran.
Oh, hi, Mark. I mean, Hallmark.
It is.
All right, Jen.
It is a Hallmark. So that's a point. The film that... So this is the film on the list I want to see least, which is On the 12th Date of Christmas. Sycorax smear test, Shelley.
Hallmark.
It is a Hallmark, so that is a point. Next up. Christmas in Paris. I Saw Mommy Quizzing's Santa Claus, Chris.
Hallmark.
It's no mark.
Ooh.
Oh!
Next up, Christmas in Vietnam. That is C3P Ho 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 Steven.
Hallmark.
It's no mark, so...
I thought it was like a trick question, like going up to mom and celebrating Christmas. I'd watch that film.
You'd watch that over Die Hard, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I would have watched that over Die Hard. Give me that. Give me Christmas in Vietnam.
Well, the next film you have is Christmas in Vienna. I Saw Mommy Quizzing Santa Claus, Chris.
Hallmark.
That one is Hallmark.
Yes.
So that's a point. Next up, we have Christmas Tango. I Saw Mommy Quizzing Santa Claus, Chris.
Hallmark.
That's no mark.
What?
The actual...
Standards Hallmark.
The actual film is Christmas Waltz. If I Only Had Christmas. That was Sycorax smear test, Shelley.
Hallmark.
That is Hallmark.
Woo!
We're back on zero.
Christmas in Evergreen, Bells Are Ringing. C3P Ho 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 Steven.
No mark.
That is a Hallmark.
This is impossible.
Next up, Christmas She Wrote.
I Saw Mommy Quizzing Santa Claus, Chris.
This is just a guess, but Hallmark?
It is a Hallmark.
Oh, wow.
Has it got Angela Lansbury in it?
No, it hasn't. But that would be great.
Oh, Christmas She Wrote.
Okay.
Next up, we have Christmas Special Delivery. So that's Sycorax smear test, Lucy.
No mark.
It is a no mark. It's actually Deliver by Christmas.
We're on one!
Next we have Cross Country Christmas.
Don't know.
I Saw Mommy Quizzing Santa Claus, Chris.
No mark.
It's Hallmark.
Aww.
This is impossible.
Next up, we have Christmas Comes All Night Long. That was C3P ho 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 Steven.
No mark.
It is a no mark.
Babe
station.
I'm just glad. I'm just glad.
Next we have Christmas Comes Twice. I saw Mommy quizzing Santa Claus Chris.
That's gotta be a no mark.
It's Hallmark.
Yeah.
And finally, we have Love Lights Hanukkah. C3P ho 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 Steven.
Hallmark.
That is Hallmark.
What?
Okay, so
to all the holidays.
Right. So David, I hope you're good with math, because I'm gonna tell you the positive and the negative scores from that round.
You've asked the very wrong person to do this.
No, I just need you to write down these two different numbers next to each team, and you can do it. It's fine. So, Sycorax smear test. They got 3 correct and 1 wrong.
That makes 2. Helping David.
Sorry. I thought he was going to be like 1-1 -1 -1
No.
Can you handle it, David? Do you want him to go slower?
I'm good.
Okay. C3P ho 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 got three correct, 4 wrong.
All right.
Three correct, 4 wrong.
And then finally, we have I Saw Mommy Quizzing Santa Claus with 4 correct, 4 wrong.
Oh.
So.
Sorry, mate. Sorry, bad.
In that round, in third place is C3P Ho Ho Ho. In second place is I Saw Mommy Quizzing Santa Claus underneath the Quizzletoe last night. And in first place is Sycorax Smear Test.
I don't know how this is happening.
We did it, Michelle. You're going to be the next president of the United States.
Okay, David, would you like to tell us the scores going into the final round?
So still in the lead is Sycorax Smear Test with 11. And then we have Mommy Quizzing Santa Claus underneath the Quizzletoe last night with 10. And C3P Ho 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 with 9.
Wow. So I thought close. We were going to be like the Russell thingy and Noel Fielding of Big Fat Quiz on this. Like, wow. Mad.
Okay.
I thought you were going to say the Russell Crowe and Noel Fielding.
Russell Crowe and the Vin Diesel of Ark.
Okay. Let's go into our final round. It's a round we'll always do. Welcome to Mojo Mind. So, this is a very special quiz where I have taken 3 random Christmas film related lists produced by the YouTube channel Watch Mojo, and I have written 10 questions where the answers will be entries on that list. So, there are 3 different sets of questions. The team in third place will choose their set first, then second place, then first place. You and your partner will also have to choose which order you answer the question, so we'll be answering one by one. So, for example, if we take Sycorax Smear Test, they would choose who would answer first between Shelley and Lucy, and then it would alternate between the two. So, note, not all of the questions will be film-related questions, but the answers will be entries on that list. So the example I've given is, what condition could you develop if you're in a car accident? And the answer is whiplash. Whiplash is the name of a film, but also the answer to that question. Does that make sense to everyone?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, David, who is choosing their set of questions first?
So it'd be C3P, ho, ho, ho.
Okay. Would you like set A, B, or C?
I was feeling lucky, Steve.
Go down the middle, Kel. Let's go with B, I say.
I'm going for set B.
Okay, so the set you've chosen is Top 10 Best Alternative Christmas Movies.
Okay.
Something tells me, given the fact you've literally just written articles somewhat along this theme, that you could be all right.
It depends what alternative means.
Okay.
So, who would like to answer first? So, basically, every odd number question, this person will answer. Every even number question, the other person will answer.
Should ladies first?
Yeah, ladies first.
Okay.
You're going then.
Nice little bit of team banter. We love to see it.
Anyway, so
who's going first? Who's going second? Okay, so Kelly going first. You will have a maximum of 4 minutes to answer these questions.
All right.
Okay. Your time starts now. Kelly, what is the first sequel to Tim Burton's Batman called?
Batman Returns.
Correct. Stephen, at the beginning of Disney's Frozen, we see a group of men collecting ice from a frozen lake to be sold to nearby towns in a similar way to harvesting crops. What would the name for this process be?
I pass.
Kelly, which film, written and co-directed by Stanley Kubrick and starring Tom Cruise and Nicole Kidman, shared its name with a song from 2010 performed by JLS featuring Tiny Temper?
Pass.
Stephen, starring Dan Aykroyd and Eddie Murphy, which 1983 social satire film sees a stockbroker and a street hustler exchange lives as part of an elaborate bet?
Trading Places.
Correct. Kelly, in a football game, if you disagree with a decision made on whether a tackle was legal or not, who do you blame?
Steve's really going to be hating me for this now.
Hello?
Because I don't
minutes.
Know.
4 minutes.
No, don't know.
Okay. Stephen, what is the opposite to a white Christmas?
I don't want to answer this.
Can I answer?
Nope.
Green a green Christmas.
Black Christmas.
I was going to say Black Easter.
I literally told you about that one earlier.
Okay.
Kelly, what is the only film that Shane Black has directed for the Marvel Cinematic Universe that happens to take place during a festive season?
Winter Soldier?
Iron Man 3. Stephen, the favourite film of film critic and general awful human being Doug Walker, which country that shares the same name as this film would you find the Amazon rainforest?
Brazil.
Correct. Kelly, named after the same phenomenon, what name is given to the supposed creatures who tamper with mechanical devices and technology, causing them to fail and have issues?
Can you repeat the question?
Named after the same phenomenon, what name is given to the supposed creatures who tamper with mechanical devices and technology, causing them to fail and have issues?
Bugs?
Gremlins.
Gremlins!
And finally, Stephen.
Stephen? The subject of great debate about Christmas, which film is the favourite film of Jake Peralta from Brooklyn Nine-Nine?
Die Hard.
Correct. With 15 seconds left, would you like to repeat any of your past questions?
Do we have to take the same ones that were posed to us, or can we answer each other's?
Well, it's kind of moot at this point because it's now just 4 minutes run. Okay, so I'll go through your past answers. At the beginning of Disney's Frozen, we see a group of men harvest, taking ice in a similar way to harvesting crops. That would be called the Ice Harvest. The film, which shared this name with a JLS song, was Eyes Wide Shut. If you disagree with a decision in the football game, you would blame the ref.
Oh.
And then everything else. So at the end of that, Kelly and Stephen, you scored 4 points.
Really mean game.
What Christmas film is called The Ref?
Yeah, Eyes Wide Shut. So Christmassy.
It's an alternative Christmas film.
Yeah.
Eyes Wide Shut is set at Christmas, and everyone forgets that.
Okay. So next we go to the team I Saw Mommy Quizzing Santa Claus Underneath the Quizzletoe last night. Would you like set A or C?
A.
You're going for set A.
Is that right with you, Chris?
Yeah, go on. I was indecisive. You were right in there, man. I can't argue with that.
Okay, and would you who is going to answer their questions first?
I'll do the first one then.
Okay.
Okay, Chris, then Kieran. Okay, so your questions are going to be on the top 10 best modern Christmas movies. Okay, are we ready?
Yes.
Your time starts now. Chris, what relation does Christmas Eve night have to Christmas Day?
Christmas Eve night, Christmas Day. Pass.
Okay. Kieran, what creature is half goat, half demon, and punishes children who misbehave, as opposed to Santa, who generally rewards good children?
Krampus.
Correct. Chris, which animated Christmas film was the first to be produced by Sony Animations and Aardman Animations as their first collaborative project?
Damn it. I think we've literally got the wrong answers here, Kieran. I'm going to pass on that one again.
Kieran, which 2006 film sees two women exchange homes for Christmas and find new positive relationships when they are there?
The Christmas Switch.
The Holiday. Chris, actor Chris Marshall returned a paycheck for a scene he filmed where three American women undressed him, claiming that he had such a good time that he'd happily do it for free. Which movie did that scene appear in?
Oh, God. Oh, is it one of those terrible ones like The Nativity?
Love Actually.
Love Actually.
Ah, balls. That's Kieran. A terrible one.
Bottle, straw.
Kieran, if a man prioritizes spending time and resources primarily to his better half, children and or parental figures, what term would wider society generally refer to him as?
Oh my God, can I please have it again?
Yep. If a man prioritizes spending time and resources primarily to his partner, children and or parental figures, what term would wider society generally refer to him as?
Is it the family man?
Correct.
Yes. I forgot that Chris. Was a Christmas film.
Which animated Christmas film stars Tom Hanks and is based off of a novel of the same name written by Chris Van Allsburg?
I have no idea. Pass.
Okay.
I've got all the questions, man.
Okay, Kieran? If you are not a good Santa, you are a what?
Bad Santa.
Correct.
Chris, director Ron Howard gave acting roles to his brother, Clint Howard, and his father, Rance Howard, in this Christmas book adaptation. What is the full name of that film?
No idea. Pass.
Okay, Kieran? Sharing the same general species name, what race of character is the Lord of the Rings character Legolas?
Elf.
Correct. You have 35 seconds. Do you want to go back to any of your passes?
Can we answer each other's?
I think given that Kelly and Stephen weren't given the chance to, I think it would be unfair to allow you to, so you have to basically
look at your... gave us the answers anyway, or some of them.
Okay, so are you calling it there?
Yeah.
Okay. So just to go over the passes then, the relationship the Christmas Eve night has to Christmas Day is that it's the night before.
That's such a good film. I love that film.
The animated film, which was the project between Sony Animations and Aardman, was Arthur Christmas. The book adaptation by Chris Van Allsburg was The Polar Express. And the full name of the film, directed by Ron Howard, was How the Grinch Stole Christmas.
Dr. Seuss's house.
So, at the end of that, you both scored 4 points, but you had more passes than Kelly and Stephen.
To be fair, Kieran got 4 points.
Okay, so now we come on to the final round. So, Shelley and Lucy, you will be answering on the top 10 animated Christmas movies.
Okay.
Who's going to go first?
Don't mind.
He's got a It's got to be bros before hoes, so Shelley needs to go first.
Yeah, I'll go first.
Okay. So, are we ready?
Yeah.
Your time starts now. Shelley, what is the name of the train that helps children travel to the North Pole in order to meet Santa Claus?
The Polar Express.
Correct. Lucy.
Yes.
If Christmas is yet to occur in 1 year, meaning that children do not have the chance to get presents from Santa, Father Christmas, what is that year?
What? A leap year? I don't know.
The year without a Santa Claus.
Oh,
okay. Shelley, who is the son of Father Christmas?
Arthur Christmas?
Correct.
It's going to be Son Christmas.
Lucy, Fred Claus.
I was going to say Jesus.
Lucy, complete this lyric. You better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
Correct. Shelley. A play on words from the original poem, which story sees Jack, unsatisfied with his current position in life, try to change it when he discovers the festive season and actively wants to take it over?
Nightmare Before Christmas.
Correct. Lucy.
Yes.
What is the name of the sentient creature who comes to life when putting a top hat upon him?
Jack Frost.
No, it's Frosty the Snowman.
Fuck's sake.
Shelley. With the original story written by Charles Dickens, but now with a famous Disney character's name in the title, which film sees Scrooge McDuck being countered by three ghosts on Christmas Eve?
Christmas Carol?
I can't accept. It's Mickey's Christmas Carol.
Oh yeah, in the title.
Okay. Lucy. A character systematically bullied for a potential birth defect until the value of that defect is recognised as having worth. Which Christmas character was subject to this abuse and capitalist torture?
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
Correct.
The Elephant Man.
We know about capitalist torture.
Shelley. Sponsored by the Coca-Cola Company after the dominant success of its original comic strip, which animated special sees its title character try to cheer themselves up by discovering the true meaning of Christmas?
Sponsored by Coca-Cola, did you say?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know. Sorry, pass.
And then Lucy, which notable animated Christmas movie includes a song about the title character sung by the voice of Tony the Tiger, Phil Arthur Ravenscroft?
Can I have that question again? I didn't hear it.
Which notable animated Christmas movie includes a song about the title character sung by the voice of Tony the Tiger, Phil Arthur Ravenscroft?
The Grinch?
I will accept it's How the Grinch Stole Christmas. So would you like to return to end your passes with 25 seconds left?
All of them.
Can you repeat my pass and then I'll have another go? My second to last one, please.
Okay, so the Coca-Cola Company, what animated special sees the character looking for the true meaning of Christmas?
Animated special.
And that's time.
Charlie Brown! Charlie Brown!
Bingo!
So the official answer given, Pingu, is incorrect. The answer was Charlie Brown Christmas.
So
I knew it.
So let's look at some of those passes. Yeah, I think it was literally just that one. It was a Charlie Brown Christmas. So at the end of that, Lucy and Shelley scored 5. So David, I can now hand over to you for the final scores.
Joint, we have C3P Ho 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 and Mummy Quizzing Santa Claus with 11 points each. And then in the top spot, we have Sycorax Smear Test with 14 points.
Yay!
Yay! Congratulations.
And as we like at Christmas, no definitive losers.
No, that's true. Yeah, Santa, you were wrong, Santa. That's the meaning of Christmas. Santa was wrong, guys.
If you didn't win, you lost. Just accept it and move on.
You took my trophy when I won the end game last time.
Who would have thought it? The two people who competed against each other in their endgame so vividly are the ones who came together the strongest.
With the dream team.
So, David, let's show them what they've won, or tell them what they've won.
Well, the first part, which I think we alluded to before the recording of the episode, is that both of you get to each choose a film that we will talk about and dedicate an episode to the future. Yes, so you have one from Shelley and one from Lucy.
So, oh, God, they're going to make it so weird.
Oh, God. So, Shelley, what is your choice as to what me and Craig are to do? God, why? Shelley, of
okay. So, I originally thought Little Miss Sunshine, because it's my favourite film.
Good choice.
But I have a reputation to uphold. So, in the holiday spirit, I'd like an episode on the Adam Sandler classic, Eight Crazy Nights. Oh. It's a Hanukkah film.
Oh, God.
That's brilliant.
Okay, and then Lucy, what film are you going to put us through?
Because I won with a question from this film when I was on my episodes, I'm going to pick 50 Shades of Grey, but I want the third one because it is definitively the worst.
Wait, 50, so 50 is freed?
Freed, yeah.
That's
the one.
Oh, dear. Oh, that's a good one.
You know, shamefully, Craig's the only one of us who's seen one of those films.
I've seen all of them. I think they're, like, surrealist Dada-esque masterpieces, honestly.
I don't know.
Craig, you're going to love it. You're going to see it. You're going to watch
it. I really don't want to love it, but...
So, Craig, the final prize...
Oh, yeah. The other prize is obviously because we want to support the cinema industry when it's fully back, when it's fully back to us. We'll be awarding each of you a £10 gift voucher to a cinema of your choice. So, okay. I'd now like to hand over to David to do the general goodbyes as I hand him back the reins of his show.
Get this bloody shit out. So, I gotta say, who would have thought you'd come out of like a big competition saying the winners are Sycorax smear test? what a winning team.
I'm just looking forward to the team image you give them for that.
So, thank you everyone for joining us, and a Merry Christmas to everyone. This will be out on, you know, the day itself, Christmas. Thank you all for joining. Obviously, lots of places and plugs and where you can all find yourselves. And thank you everyone for joining. So should we go first with C3P Ho Ho Ho? Kelly, where can we catch yourself?
Yeah, so I'm over on Twitter, Instagram, and my sort of half-dead blog, but it will be coming back hopefully in the new year. Kelly Lou Bishop, it's all the same.
Awesome. Yeah, some nice details pieces. I was watching Ratatouille the other day. I was like, Ken needs to do Ratatouille next.
I'll do Ratatouille for you.
Yeah, there you go. I might have had 50 Shades Freed, but I'm still able to recommend a film to somebody. Steve, where can we catch yourself?
Yeah, so you can catch me on Twitter and Instagram. On Instagram, it's just sjoneslist, and on Twitter, it's unknownsteve_. And I've just started a new writing job with Empora, and they sort of focus on sport and adventure. So if you want to read some interesting sport and adventure articles, get yourself over them.
Awesome. So... yeah, and we were also joined by Mommy quizzing Santa Claus underneath the quizzle toe last night. Chris, where can we catch yourself?
You can catch me, Christopher Maxwell, on Facebook and with Dramatic Moose Productions on Facebook. And stay tuned for this Friday at 7 p.m. for Dramatic Moose Presents All I Want for Christmas, a short audio play. And next week, or the week after, on the build-up to Christmas, A Christmas Carol, a joint production of three companies. Thank you.
Awesome. Kieran?
Thanks. I personally am not on social media anymore, but if you like video games, be sure to check out Purple Ghosts, the Purple Ghost Gaming Podcast, and that's on Facebook and Twitter as well.
But the game didn't go that badly, Kieran. You don't have to leave social media. You know, people chasing it. How could you not know it was on for Christmas?
Cancelled.
People throwing like flaming garbage at his head. Like, how dare you? I think in that last one, it was a case of like, if it was reversed, it would have been a completely different game. Like the animations and stuff. It was like, it was so such a tense ending.
I think it was the round on the friggin'... Hallmark stuff. It's just impossible.
Yeah, killer. So, and the winners, Sycorax, smear test, Shelley, where can we catch yourself?
Instagram at knitwearcathair for general memery and silly things.
And if you see a van outside your house, it's not Shelley. Don't please assume she
is. Yeah, don't come and shout at me. Don't be a gammon. Come on.
And Lucy.
Hi.
Where can we catch yourself?
Oh, okay. So I've deleted my OnlyFans now. I was just making too much money, and I don't want to get above my station.
We've had an update.
Yeah, yeah. Thanks. Mm.
So yeah, the OnlyFans is gone now, so you can't find me there. But I am on YouTube. If you just search Lucy Fair Queen, I think I come up. And I'm on Instagram, although I don't really post there anymore because it's just crap now, isn't it? But let's be honest, it's not a bit.
Last time Facebook's just crap now, and now this time it's Instagram.
Yeah,
it's just steadily going on.
I'm on Twitter as Lucy Fair Queen. My nan's got a Twitter, Nanolin Wales, so you can follow Nanolin.
This is the most unconventional plug I've ever seen.
Nan's really funny on Twitter. She's part of the Free Wales Army, so she like tweets about Welsh independence a lot. It's really cute. Nanolin. She's in some of my videos. She's adorable.
Awesome.
And that's it, yeah. If you want to see pictures of me naked, you'll have to come to me like person to person now because it's not on the internet anymore. I'm sorry, everyone. That's it. Yeah, I do YouTube sometimes if I can be bothered. I might do a Christmas video.
Awesome.
I might not. We'll see.
Well, thank you for joining us, everyone. It's been loads of fun. It's been a crazy night of festivities, and we didn't even have drink, you know. But I'm sure you'll all be getting, you know, festive and drunk at the Christmas period. You can catch us at all our socials on Well Good Movies on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter as well. And you can catch us on our website, which is freshtakehub.com/wellgoodmovies. And yeah, thank you, Craig. Anything else from yourself? We've got a last message before we go after Craig.
So from me, all I have to say is Merry Endgame to all, and to all a good fight.
Okay.
So yeah, Merry Christmas. This is from Craig. He found this exclusively online. If you notice, it said Jesus loves you in small text.
That's incredible. Oh my
Jesus
god.
Loves you. Yeah. I don't think he does.
So we've got another message from that is Jesus, guys.
Big
that's
man's
Jesus.
Back.
Yeah.
This is Hans, which is happening on the table.
Remember Shelley.
Jesus, dad.
Isn't Jesus the son of Santa Claus? No. So we have a last Christmas message from Santa, everyone.
Hello, it's me, the real Father Christmas. And I've been asked by Craig David, or is that Craig and David? Oh, David and Craig. Anyway, I've been asked to wish all the followers of Fresh Take and the listeners of Well Good Movies a very Merry Christmas. David and Craig would like to thank all of their guest writers, but most importantly, all you people at home for all your support. And they look forward to bringing you plenty of treats in 2021. So, Nadolig Slawin and a Happy New Year. Happy New Year, everybody. Bye-bye.
After all the dirty jokes and smut we've had in this one, what a nice way to end.
So wholesome.
Nadolig Slawin.
Yes. Nice treats in the new year, like 50 Shades Freed and 8 Crazy
And 8
Nights.
Crazy Nights.
Yay.
I might change it to Little Miss Sunshine, depending, because, I mean,
depends
yeah,
how nice you're feeling.
Maybe.
Depending on how many death threats I send.
Split it down the middle. It's like, so split it down the middle. Let them watch half of Little Miss Sunshine and half of 8 Crazy Nights and then just do a review of it.
I don't want that to be a narrative I end up creating.
So, thank you, everyone. Merry Christmas. Have a happy new year.
Bye.
And thank you for joining us. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Nice little bit of team banter. We love to see it.